First of the next question is, God chose David to be anointed with a horn of oil. What should I do to receive the same anointing? Is fervent prayer at the appointed time enough? God chose David to be anointed with a horn of oil. What should I do to receive the same anointing? Is fervent prayer at the appointed time is enough?
Yeah, when we interpret the characters of the Old Testament, when we study about them and then implement it into our lives, and we are New Testament believers. I remember a couple of scriptures. One is in Corinthians and one is in Romans, where the scripture says, one is in 1 Corinthians 10, the other might be in Romans 15, where the scripture says, all the Old Testament stories are written to us as examples, as warnings, as encouragement for us. So, man of God, Uncle Jeyaraj, gave us wonderful messages on the anointing of David. Okay, so what do we do? Is there any formula to receive David's anointing? Absolutely not. But is there a formula to receive the Holy Spirit baptism? There's no formula. The Bible talks about, you know, thirsting after God, Isaiah 44. The Bible talks about asking God, Luke 11, 9, how much more your Heavenly Father will give the Holy Spirit to those who ask Him. So we can do all those things, putting our faith in Jesus, who is actually the baptizer in the Spirit. The baptizer in the Spirit is the Lord Jesus Himself. But will Jesus make you exactly like David? No. Okay, David had a unique plan for him, and he executed the plan and he slept. That's what we read in Acts 13, and I think it's verses 36. But you can learn from the good things that David did and implement it in your life, but you still have your own unique plan of God for your life. So I think you must be concerned about that. And David and all these wonderful characters, we read about them in Isaiah in Hebrews 11, will keep inspiring you to actually become more and more, not like David, but more and more like Christ. Amen. So that's the focus of the Bible.